and the High Regency. Hotel. I'm talking about the plush, humongous Hyatt Regency on International Drive. I'm not talking about any Super 8 or Motel 6. I'm talking about a huge facility on International Drive. Amen. I met, there was a conference that was being held there, and it was on bone transplant. They're transplanting livers, as you know. And they are transplanting hearts and other things of the human body. Is there a witness in this? This conference was finally at the stage of studying bone transplant. I spoke with a doctor who is a dental surgeon, and he's the one that you would go to if you've got missing teeth. And he would attach it to the bones of the mouth. Now we got a witness. And you can smile without paste or glue.
All right now.
He went through the whole procedure with me, and when he found out that I was your pastor,
all right,
and a doctor of theology and leadership, he said, Dr. Al, let me tell you something. He said, I spent all day. Thank you, Sister Bertha. I spent all day talking about bone transplant. But I remember that some time ago, evolutionists were talking about the fact that there was no God. I looked at him and I said, you are a doctor of dentistry? And you're about to tell me about what some evolutionists have said? And I can hear something say, calm down.
Don't do it.
And then he said, do you know that there is a study that is complete that said this thing is that science has proved that there is a God? I said, all right then. And then he went on to tell me, and I wanted to stop it and get a microphone as well as a ballpoint pen or something to write down all of the details of the study. And he said, you don't have to do that. Just remember that the scientists have already established that there must be a God.
Yes,
oh, is there anybody in this house?
It is.
And he went on to say, which I'm just praising God that I'm able to tell you now, is that the scientists found that while our bodies are made up of proteins, and it takes years to develop the same kind of protein that will mesh with the other things that are in the human body.
Yeah.
And then he said, existing for 4.9 billion years. And it takes the proteins and the other elements in which they have to intersect with to make the human body almost 10 billion years. Nobody got that. And he said, Dr. Rebell, there hasn't been enough time. The earth hasn't been in existence long enough for the human body.
Yeah.
In schoolrooms where now recorded testimonies that when they were near death experiences, in death experiences, is that they came back a different way. Their lives were not the same. I can't understand, Lord, why we can come to church, why we can sing God's songs, why we can raise our hands, why we can say amen and never change. And look at things differently. Studies on Tuesday night, where we looked at Ruth 3, we can look at Ruth 4 and we will come to the circumstance that God wants us to do things differently. I'm not God. Thank God for that. But aren't you sick and tired of being sick and tired of people doing the same thing, hitting the head against the wall, and no change? Have we got one? I look around me and I say, why isn't there a change amongst us? Why is it, Alvin White Jr., that you have difficulty in change? And after all these years, the Lord has given me an answer. Because I spend my energy looking at the results. I've got a measuring stick as I walk through life. And I'm saying, are we there yet? I wake up every morning and I said, Lord, you know I've been praying for 3 days. I've been living for you for 4 or 5 months. I'm wondering when, Lord, are you going to show me that my faith and my trust is going to amount to something? And if I'm the only one here, that's all right, because I want to leave this morning with the testimony is that stop checking out the results. Stop measuring every day. Oh, he must not hurt. Later on, is that you'll find out that the orange tree never looks back. It just keeps on growing. Ruth, what enters into our lives, and I'll walk you through the scripture that says that she continued to sow. How does she sow? Did she sowed with kindness? She sowed with, and it was sown. She sowed with passion. All the way back to the first chapter of Ruth, is that you'll see that after all the circumstances had happened to the children of Israel, Elimelech and Naomi and Chilion, they were bitter. They said, sitting up, in my interpretation, sitting up at a high school auditorium. When everybody else has a beautiful church.
All right. All right.
They said, Lord, why us? Well, they found out that while they thought they were going to a land full of food and comfort, is that that land soon became desolate. Even to the extent that they had to turn around and go back home. But not until Emily had died, not until Ruth's husband had died, and not until Ruth's brother-in-law had passed. And none of that transpired. All of that, brother, had transpired before they turned back. If all of that situation is happening over here, I just work to go home. And Naomi. And as I said last Sunday, Naomi was so, well, I almost said something. Just say that she was so mad. She was stretched.
Yes, sir.
That the Lord would do her
all right.
Like he had in her eyes done.
All right.
Have we got a witness?
Right.
Is there anybody here who's gone through that situation?
Yes, sir.
Don't be afraid to admit it. In fact, you should admit it.
Right.
Is that I turned against God.
Amen.
Because he should have long blaming God or somebody else. We're good in blaming it. It was. And never thought about it. May have been you were looking at results. You had become a project analyst on results seeking. And didn't know what you were looking at. Because you look at a particular result, and in your eyes and my eyes, it looked a certain way. But you need to know that when you're looking at results and you're not God, is that you may be looking at a caterpillar.
All right.
I see.
That will turn to a butterfly. You may, in your eyes, be looking at just what you thought was a worm.
All right.
And it's getting ready.
Yes, sir.
To fly away in beauty.
Yeah.
Where people will be looking and saying, oh, that's a damnable object crawling around.
Yeah.
But oh, look at it fly. Look at it fly away.
Yeah.
As a butterfly.
Yeah.
Allow the caterpillar experience in Moab turn to a butterfly back in their hometown. Have you got a witness? And this is all through those situations, Ruth stayed in belief of how God had directed her life.
Amen.
And we got to read the very first time, and a point is that you'll find